Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of the retro cyberspace universe in the classic sci-fi movie, Tron. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll transform our subject into a glowing object of colorful sharp lines and motion trails, as well as create a grid that will transform in part two into a glowing floor. We'll finish our world by adding our subject's reflection, a dark, ominous, stormy sky, and then create an alternate one-color version. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. To ensure that your results will look similar to mine, let's check its size and resolution. Go to Image and Image Size. Make its resolution 150 pixels per inch and its height 2000 pixels. Its width will automatically change to another amount based on the height. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Next, we'll separate the subject from its background by making a selection around the subject. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, make its radius 5 to 10 pixels, and then drag your tool over your subject to select it. If you need to remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Once you've made your selection, press Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac to cut and copy your subject to its own layer. We're going to use the shape of the cutout subject later, so click the icon at the upper right of your Layers panel and click Duplicate Layer. Open the flyout list and click New. Type in Shape and click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your original photo. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the new layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. We'll fill the empty layer with white, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is your background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete to fill the layer with white. Next, we'll convert our visible image into a smart object so we can modify it and even replace it without having to redo most of the effects that we'll be adding to it. To do this, make the bottom layer active and shift-click on the top layer to make all the layers active. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Find Edges. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Invert. Shift-click on your subject to make it active as well, and convert both layers into a smart object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command-J. Change the blend mode to Linear Dodge. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 50 pixels and click OK. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Brightness Contrast. To restrict the adjustment layer to affect just the one layer below it, we'll need to clip it to that layer. To do this, either click the Clipping Mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Make the brightness and contrast 100 each. Shift-click on the bottom layer to make all the layers active and convert them into a smart object. Make a copy of the layer and change the blend mode to Linear Dodge. Reduce its opacity to 60%. Go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Path Blur. If you don't have Path Blur because you're working on an earlier version of Photoshop, I'll show you a workaround in a minute. Basically, the Path Blur creates motion blurs along paths. In the center, you'll see a horizontal arrow. At the end of the arrowhead will be the point where your motion blur will end. Drag the arrowhead to the left or right, depending on the direction and distance you want your motion blur to end. The positions of the arrow will also determine the angle of the blur. Drag the other end of the arrow to the opposite end of your subject and position it to where you want the blur to originate. Dragging the middle point of the arrow will bend or arc the blur along the path. However, for this example, I don't want the motion blur to bend. Make sure Basic Blur is chosen and uncheck Centered Blur. Centered Blur basically blurs the pixels on both sides. However, in this case, we want a more fluid and directional blur. To adjust the speed, drag the speed slider, which will determine the amount of path blur you want to apply to the image. To adjust the speed of the endpoint, drag the endpoint speed slider to the right or left. In this case, we'll drag it all the way to the left. You can taper the blur as well. A higher taper value will trail off the blur gradually, but for this example, we'll keep the taper at 0%. Then, click OK. Make a copy of the active layer to intensify the effect. If you don't have the Path Blur filter, go to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Set the distance all the way to the right at 2000 pixels and drag the angle to a direction that you want for your motion blur. Then click OK. Click the layer mask of Motion Blur to make it active and open your gradient tool. Make sure your linear gradient icon is active and click the gradient bar. Click the black-white box and click OK. Drag the tool approximately halfway across your subject and release. Make a copy of your active layer to intensify the motion trail effect. At this point, the rest of the steps will be the same whether or not you have the Path Blur filter. Shift-click on the bottom layer to make all the layers active and convert them into a smart object. Next, we'll create a pattern that we'll make into a grid that will ultimately become our floor. Create a new document by going to File and New. Make the width and the height 100 pixels each and the resolution 72 pixels per inch. Click the color box and pick black. Then click OK on both windows. To fit your image onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the lock icon to unlock the layer and double-click the thumbnail to open its layer styles. Click Stroke. Make the size 2 pixels and the position inside. Click the color box and pick white. Then click OK on both windows. Go to Edit and Define Pattern. Then click OK. Click the X to the right of the tab of the document, and when you see this message, click No. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Pattern. Then click OK. In Part 2, we'll transform the grid into Tron's glowing floor and complete our cyberspace video game world. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.